38. That is George Lucas's first movie that he ever made. It stars Robert Duvall. He plays the title character, and his name is THX-1138. Okay? Now, I want a little thumbs up, thumbs down action. Thumbs up or thumbs down if you think George Lucas at least is in the know on the Elite's plan or is a member of the Elite's. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Okay. I think it's a... Okay, so hey, welcome to the show, Simple Truths. Well, I'm pretty sure he is, Simple Truths, and I'm going to tell you why. I watched that movie about a year ago again. Actually, I'd never seen it before. I rented it on Netflix. And George Lucas, hold on, who made Star Wars. Yes. George Lucas has this habit of fucking with his movies, right? He screwed up the first Star Wars. He put all kinds of retarded gay shit in there digitally. He loves to remaster his movies. Well, guess what? He remastered THX-1138. And now there is available on DVD. I highly recommend you go either download it wherever you download it, or you go rent it, or get it from Netflix, or go buy it. It's a pretty good movie for a dystopic movie. He remastered THX-1138, and now there is a director's cut, and that is what I rented from Netflix. It was THX-1138, the director's cut, okay? And normally, when you get the director's cut, you get the DVD commentary, okay? He changed it a little, Big C. He added some digital shit in there. Nothing major, though. He didn't change the story. Now, if you know, now on this DVD, there is this commentary, and George Lucas does the commentary. Okay, now, I'm going to give you a quick spoiler. It's here, I'll type it in. It's THX-1138. That's the name of the movie. And in this movie... I'm going to give you a quick spoiler, but you ain't going to miss much. Robert Duvall plays THX-1138, and he is trying, at some point decides he wants to get out of this society in which they live, which is a technocratic, totalitarian, computer-controlled, dystopic world. Okay? And at the end of the movie, he does succeed in getting out of the movie, or getting out of the world. And when he gets out, guess where he comes to? He crawls up out of the ground, because the entire city is located under the ground, like an ant farm. That's why I referred to Project Venus as a human ant farm. They live underground. And when he comes up out of the ground, oddly enough, just to fuck with you a little more, he comes up to a rising sun. That's the final image in the scene, is him standing in front of a rising sun. Okay? Now, that's not the fucking kicker. You have to get the director's cut with Lucas's commentary, and let me tell you why. Because I watch the DVD's director commentary if I'm interested enough in the director, and being a fan of Star Wars, being a fan of Lucas, I wanted to hear what he had to say about his first movie, which was a gnarly dystopic movie. And within the first 20 minutes of the movie, he's talking about the world in which THX-1138 lives. He's talking about this dystopic society. And what George Lucas says, and I'm going to paraphrase here, he says, this is the type of society that the elites want to see, and then this is the direct quote, if they have their way. This is coming out of Lucas's mouth. Go rent it. Go rent it. Go get your THX-1138 director's cut on and listen to George Lucas, who is arguably